I'm horrible at memorizing, but yet through music, it's just a tool that connects with my brain and just allows me to soak in the scripture in a new way.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked.
Welcome to Bible Memory Goal. My name is Josh, and you just heard from Zach Fitzsimmons, obviously a very talented musician, a worship leader up in Minnesota in the United States, who has put a number of psalms word for word to music and available on streaming platforms, on YouTube, and a number of different places. Now, if you're the kind of person that enjoys memorizing scripture through song, you're not alone. Even Zach admits that he doesn't think he's great at memorizing the Bible, but he does have that skill that God's given him with music, and that is the way that he really gets to enjoy meditating and spending time in God's Word. And if you're the person that really wants to learn how to do this, Zach's going to walk us a little bit through how you can put scripture to song. Now, as I said, he is very, very talented at what he does, and I've noticed even the background of some of his videos that he's got professional-looking equipment. So that's what I asked him about to get started.
Well, I mean, I've had a passion for music since the beginning, but my full-time job is leading, you know, worship music in the church. So I've been doing that full-time for 12 or 13 years now. So, but the Psalms has really just been maybe the last 5 or 6 years that have really just kind of taken off with these guys. So,
How many, I saw a list of them on your website, but I don't know if that's updated or not. How many of the Psalms have you put word for word to music?
So there was 14 on the first collection, and I'm releasing another collection actually on March 3rd that'll have another 8. So I guess whatever that is, 22? Am I doing the math right? Yeah.
That's awesome.
So not that many really, but it's like they take forever. I mean, to really do like word for word and to kind of figure out melody wise and then record them, it just takes a long time. So
Oh, absolutely. I can only imagine. So I mean, I guess that's a great place to start there. First of all, would you mind bringing me through the process of what was it that inspired you to go? I mean, because you've been leading worship, obviously, for a long time. Sure. So you could have gone into just writing worship songs or going that route. But instead, you decided to put Psalms, not just like kind of, you know, I mean, I know Shane and Shane, I love what they do. And there's a lot of kind of just adaptation that happens there that I love and I appreciate. But you made it specific. I want to do word for word. What led to that?
Yeah, I mean, it started in 2016. The lead pastor was taking us through, it was just called Psalms in the Summer or something like that. It was just a summer series. And I thought, you know, wouldn't it be cool if we could write music and melodies to these Psalms word for word and then keep up with the sermon series, basically. So like do one a week and just crank them out and then have them recorded so the congregation can listen to them the following week and just a different way to soak in the scriptures. But I had no idea if I could do it. I was just like, let's give it a shot, you know, and it's like kind of low pressure because nobody asked me to do it. I was just like, I think that'd be cool. And I think the congregation would probably appreciate that. And so I knew about 3 weeks ahead of time what Psalms he was doing that summer. So at least I had a couple of weeks to try to start working it out. Started right at the beginning with Psalm 1, and it's like, okay, I think I can do this. You know, it's just, there's something that God put in me that I can just hear melodies just easily. Mm-hmm. So that part's in a sense easy. The tricky part is like none of these lines rhyme. You know, you're trying to do your best to make it somewhat listenable and not just total weird. So I sometimes will even turn pieces into almost what would be like a chorus, even though there was probably no chorus maybe in the Hebrew poetry. Maybe there's some times when they repeat things or whatnot, but so that, I think that just helps people to kind of grab hold of it. And then as we kind of got some momentum going, people are like, man, we love these, keep on making them, keep on doing it. Like, I'm loving it too. Like, I'm soaking in the scriptures in a new way as you do it. At least for me, when I'm going through it, I mean, it's probably hundreds of times going through the psalm in the course of the week, trying to put music and melody to it. And by the end, I'm like, I know this psalm better than I could have known it just reading through it, you know, that kind of a thing. So, yeah.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
So it's been a great blessing to me, but it's just kind of cool that it's a blessing to other people too.
Yeah. I always ask this to people that put scripture to music. And so I'm curious to hear from your perspective. When you are going to just say the psalm,
yeah,
do you find it hard to not like sing it in a melody, or can you say it through just kind of verbally?
Honestly, I'm horrible at just speaking it. I almost have to have a guitar in my hand to be able to just sing it and then sing the words and stuff, it's kind of funny that you're even interviewing me, because it looks like a lot of the people you're interviewing like are really gifted at memorization or have figured out ways to memorize scripture. I'm horrible at memorizing, but yet through music, it's just a tool that connects with my brain and just allows me to soak in the scripture in a new way. So, yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's funny you even say that, because I think a lot of people, and I put myself in this camp as well, people think that I'm like super good at memorizing. And I think it's really just a matter of, are you willing to put in the time? And for you, like what gives you maybe the motivation to put in the time is putting it to music. But you're doing it, you know, 100 times, and that's what's really getting it into your brain. Sure. So, I mean, that was one of my questions for you earlier, having to do with, you know, just melody. I mean, obviously things aren't rhyming if you're going word for word, at least not all the time.
Right.
So do you find that like, is creating that melody, it sounds like that's kind of comes naturally, but what then is the hardest part of really bringing that song to life?
Yeah, well, I mean, it kind of starts with, you know, reading through and like, what is the psalm about? I mean, is it happy? Is it a lament? Is it, you know, it kind of starts there and kind of the feel. And then I don't know. I'll usually sit. It's usually by guitar because that's the most natural instrument. But it could be whatever. I got this cool instrument that's called an Irish bouzouki. Sometimes I'll sit down with that thing. It's like a giant mandolin. Anyway, usually it's a guitar. And I'll just kind of like start with maybe a verse or two, and just kind of like, what could this feel like? What does this sound like? And sometimes, like I just finished Psalm 96 2 weeks ago. But I started it 5 years ago. Like sometimes it just doesn't come super quick. Like I maybe had music and melodies the first six verses, and that's all that was coming to me. But I kept stuff recorded so I could go back to it and check on it, you know, and revisit it. But there's others that I sit down and a half an hour later I'm like, we got it. So it kind of depends on what God wants to give in the moment, and I'm just happy to receive whatever He's ready to give. So yeah.
Earlier, you said that you were doing this based on a summer series on the Psalms. What are you doing? Like, how are you choosing the Psalms right now moving forward?
Yeah, that's a good question. It has been, a lot of it's been even inspired by people asking for particular Psalms being done. I've got just the YouTube group. There's just people all over the world that are using these, which is super fun. But then I'll ask them, I'm like, you know, what would be some of your favorite psalms to have done? Because it is an investment of time. So I want to make sure that, I mean, any psalm is valuable, obviously, but I'd love to have particular ones that are impactful for more than just me, too. So, it's been a little bit random, to be honest, and it's just kind of more based on people's suggestions of what they're looking for. So,
And for those of you that are watching or listening right now, if you want to go, I'll be linking obviously to your YouTube channel and your website in the show notes or in the description of the video. But it's, you know, Zach Fitzsimmons Music, if you just wanted to search for it directly. For those people that, you know, there's so many different methods for memorizing scripture. And I think a lot of people don't even realize that when they first start out in memorizing. They think that, you know, the way that we grew up with just repeating it over and over and over again is possibly the only way. And I love being able to talk to people like yourself where, you know, you've obviously taken a skill set that God's given you, music, and been able to apply that to something. Do you think it's possible, like, is there... what I don't want to do is I don't want it to make it seem like you have to be a you know, professional musician in order to do something like this. Obviously, they can listen to your music, but if somebody wanted to write their own song to, you know, scripture, one, do you think it's possible? And then two, you know, if so, even if they're not super talented musicians, what tips or recommendations would you give them?
Yeah, I mean, I would I think anybody can do it if you're willing, kind of like you said, if you're willing to put the time into it, and that's something you're passionate about doing, I think anybody can do it. I've actually had, when I first started this, I didn't even realize anybody else was actually doing this kind of thing, but there have, of course, there's other folks that are doing word for word songs out there. But the other fun thing that's happened too, again, just connecting with people all over the world through YouTube, is people start sending me versions of stuff that they've done. And sometimes it's super simple. You know what I mean? It's just like four chords and they just kind of, they find some sort of groove and it just works, you know? And they, I can tell they maybe don't have fancy recording equipment or, you know, deep understanding of maybe even musically what they're playing, but it's just like, it works, you know, and it works for them. And so it really doesn't matter, especially if your purpose is just like, I want to just soak in the psalm in a new way through music. Basically, whatever comes out that connects with your heart, that's a win. So yeah. So I don't know as far as advice, other than just like, just do it and just kind of just push forward and find a 3-4 chord pattern and just start singing melodies and see what comes out.
Yeah. Yeah. And if it's anything like, you know, I honestly haven't put any scripture. No, I take that back. I have done one psalm to music a number of years back, a couple of them now. And like, I think the thing that I always think about when I'm talking to other people that may not think of themselves as like super musicians is it's like even good musicians that I know, the first thing that they put out there, like, it's not like it's their, like it's not a top 40 hit or anything. And it doesn't have to be, especially in this case. It's just put something out there that gives you a reason to listen over and over again, because that's what's really going to put it into your brain. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. That's good.
Well, two other things quickly. First of all, this coming from, another musician, Taylor or Martin? I think I see you playing a Martin. Is that it?
usually a Martin for acoustic. Yeah.
All right. What kind of Martin do you have? It's a beautiful guitar.
I honestly don't even know. It's just kind of my workhorse guitar. I mean, it's like an artist series something. I don't even know what the model number is or anything like that. I'm not really as many instruments as I have. I'm not like a gear junkie where I really even. I'm just like they're just tools to me.
Yeah.
But I've probably got, I don't know, maybe 15 instruments or something in the other room. It's just, I love even collecting odd instruments. I use on the new album coming out, the first song is Psalm 117, which is super, super short. I think it's like a verse or two long. And we actually are using a harmonium on that. I don't know if you know what a harmonium is,
yes.
But it's like that kind of pump organ thing or whatever. It's just like, it's perfect. So I just love variety. And so if you listen to any of these that I put together, you'll be like, what genre is he even playing right now? It's just like, I'm all over the map. I feel like that's, at least to me, that's what keeps it interesting for me. And I think that, especially some of these longer psalms, sometimes that variety kind of helps you stay engaged all the way through. So, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. I can imagine that, because you don't want it to be too repetitive or too, like, especially for the longer psalms, you want to add that variety in.
Yeah, it's an interesting mix, because if you can make some things sort of repetitive, it gives you something to grab hold of, right? But too much of the same thing, you're just like, okay, change directions a little bit to kind of keep me interested. So, yeah.
Well, Zach, can I put you on the spot? I know I didn't prep you for this, and you can say no right off the bat, but would you be willing to like grab your guitar real quick and just like play us a bar or two of something that either you've already written or you're in one of the psalms that you're in the process of writing?
Sure. Yep. I could do that. I've got, I'll grab this one right here.
You know a musician when he has to look on both sides of himself and go, which one? Oh, I'll grab that one.
this is a little, speaking of Martin, this little baby Martin on this guy, but nice. It's good for a purpose like this. So I'll give you a little taste of the very first one I ever did, which is Psalm 1. So should I just go for it?
Go for it, man.
Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sin. in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by the streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither, and all that he does he prospers. He prospers. The wicked are not so, but are like chaff that the wind drives away. Therefore the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous. Oh, oh. But the way of the wicked will perish. I want to be like a tree planted by the streams of water that yields its fruit in its season. Its leaf does not wither, and all that he does, he prospers. He prospers.
What a treat to have Zach play Psalm 1 for us here on the podcast. If you want to hear more of that kind of music, you can go to YouTube and find Zac Fitzsimmons Music. I'll have links below this video. You can also look at psalmsongswordforword.com, which is his website, again, linked to below, where you can find and download the chord charts. He'll explain how he plays these different songs, the different recordings that you can use, all of that available for free on his website. So I hope you'll go there and support him and everything that he's doing. Thank you for taking this time with me. If you want to learn more about memorizing God's word, we've got a lot of great videos here that you can watch next. And of course, subscribe if you haven't already. God bless.